Sir, how are you?
I'm good, sir. Thank you.
So you're coming from which place?
I'm coming from Delhi, sir.
You're coming from Delhi?
Yes, sir.
So you stay in Delhi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you came by which train?
I came by Bhopal Shatabdi, sir.
Bhopal Shatabdi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When did you reach?
So I reached here by 1:30 p.m., sir.
Okay. So and your reporting time was?
My reporting time was 2 p.m., sir.
2 p.m.
But I reached a day before my reporting day.
Okay, you came one day before.
Yes, sir.
So what did you do in that one day?
Sir, that one day, sir, after I came back, I settled at the EME center, sir. My father's postmate is posted there. So I had a guest room booked for me. And I settled myself there. And in the evening, I went for a walk, sir. I played football also there. And once I came back, I did some revision. I wanted to prepare for my PPDT and intelligence test. So I did some revision, practiced certain points that I felt that I need to I had to put more focus on. That's it, sir.
Okay, so Rishabh, tell me something about yourself, about your education qualification, your marks you score in 10th and 12th standard, about your hobbies and interest, what are games do you play? Which is your favorite game? Who's your favorite player? Something about your family, who all are there in your family and what are they all doing? About your friends, who all are your best friends? Who among them is your best friend? What is one quality of your best friend that you like the most? One quality of your best friend that you don't like?
Sir, my name is Rishabh Sood. I am 22 and a half years old. I am coming from Delhi. My father's name is Colonel Ritu Sood. He is presently posted in Chikowabad 5UP NCC. My mother's name is Sarita Sood. She is a teacher in Mount St. Mary School. And I have a younger brother who is 4 years younger to me and is presently pursuing BCom Honours from Deen Dayal Upadhyay College, Delhi University. Sir, I did my 10th from Mount St. Mary School, Delhi Cant. I secured 8.4 CGPA. I did my 12th from the same school. I secured 84% in science stream. And I did my graduation in Sri Guru Nanak Dev Khalsa College, Delhi University and secured 58% in economics honours. Sir, my hobbies and interests include, I love doing dancing and travelling. Sports has been an integral part of my life. I have been always involved in sports. I was part of 3 school teams in my school and I was part of, I was the captain of my college badminton team. I had the opportunity and the privilege of attending the national camp for ball badminton. As far as the co-curricular activities include, in my school I was part of my public speaking team and I was the captain of my house. In my college, sir, I was part of NCC throughout the 3 years. I was junior under officer and in my first year I was the captain of I was part of my Western dance group, college Western dance team, and also throughout the 3 years I was part of Art and Culture Society, which is the public organization which conducts various college events such as festivals and freshers throughout the 3 years. In my third year, I was the public relations manager in the same society, sir. Sir, I have a lot of friends. Being from sports background and involved in co-curricular activities, I have a number of friends. But my best friend's name is Ulysses Mendoza. He's from Goa, and his father is posted in his father is in Navy. So the best thing I like about Ulysses is that he works in an event management company, and for him, as a part of his job, he has to manage his team of laborers. At the same time, he has to pull off big meetings in, through high profile clients. So he has this ability to always engage himself in and convince and extract results from somebody who is a laborer and somebody who is from a high strata. So the way he is able to convince and the way he is able to represent his company in front of all these people, I feel that that is something I always learn from him, sir. Sir, that's all, sir.
Okay, you didn't tell about his quality that you don't like in him?
Sorry, sir. Sir, the one quality that I don't like in him is that, sir, he stays alone, sir. So, for him, his time management skills should be better. So I always advise him that his time management skills are not that good. Being in event management company, sir, he has to be very particular about his time management and how he organizes his time. So I have also worked with him in certain projects, and I have always felt that few of his tasks were not completed as per his plan. So I have always advised him, and I still advise him, that before he does a pull off such project, he must make a retro planning, and with the help of retro planning, he must stick to that planning so that he adheres by the timing.
So, Rishabh, what are you doing nowadays?
So, I'm presently working in Decathlon as a sports leader.
As a sports leader?
Yes.
So, what's your job profile?
So, my job profile is that of a sports leader. So, I'm a sports leader for water sports. Decathlon showcases more than 50 sports. And in my store, which is located in Huda City Center, I'm part of all the water sports. So, I manage all the water sports, from stocks to sales, to partnerships and to organizing events. All water sports things are handled by me, sir.
Okay. So, Rishabh, so what is your routine nowadays? Like, tell me something about your daily routine.
Sir, I have two shifts. I work 6 days a week. If I tell you my morning shift routine, so my morning shift starts from My morning shift starts from 8 a.m. in the morning till 5 p.m. in the evening. So, sir, I get up at 6:30. I freshen up, get ready for work, have my breakfast, and leave for my work. Reach my store by 8 and do my shift. And I finish my shift at 5 p.m. Thereby, I come back at home at 6 p.m. So after that, it is my daily. I always make sure that I involve myself into sports. So, sir, I go in the evening to Defence Services Officers Institute, which is located close to my house, and I go there to play. So, I spend about 2 hours there. So, from 6 to say about 8, 8:30, I am always there. So, by 9, I reach home. I have my dinner, freshen up, and from 9, while having dinner, that's the time I spend with my family, sir. This time I engage in knowing about how my mother's routine was, how my brother's routine was, and if my father is in the city, he joins me during the game, or we have a chat during this time. So this is a family time where we eat together, we talk, and we involve ourselves into watching live comedy on television, sir. So after this, at around 10 o'clock, I study. I had my CDS exam on the 19th, so I was preparing for it, and about 12:31, I prepare for my CDS exam, and I sleep by 12:31. So when I have evening shifts, I repeat the same routine. It's just that my evening shift starts from 2 p.m. So I leave the house by 1:15 p.m. and I do my morning workouts. So the evening games I play in the morning, I get up at 6:30, I go for games at 7, and by 9 I have my breakfast and get ready. And in the morning, I spend time with studying for my CDS exam, and then I leave at 1:15, and my shift gets over at 10. So I reach home by 10:45, 11, because I have, by going back, I receive some traffic midway. And after reaching home at 11, I sleep by 11:30, 12.
Okay, so Rishabh, you have done your 10th and 12th from?
The Mount St. Mary School.
Mount St. Mary School. Okay. So, Rishabh, this is your first SSB?
No, sir, this is my third SSB.
Third SSB. What happened last two times?
So I got conferenced out both the times.
Okay. Which entry?
So, this was NCC special entry, sir.
Both the times, NCC special entry?
Both the times.
Okay. So, what do you think? Where did you land?
Sir, as far as my performance goes, I was very convinced with my performance, sir. But, like my psychologist said, sir, before while briefing us, he said that they look for a particular personality which fits in their frame. So, sir, as far as my performance goes, I gave my best, but I believe that my performance didn't suit that framework, and that's why I think so, sir, I didn't get rewarded.
Okay, so how did you prepare this time?
Sir, this time I made certain changes. After my last SSB, I realized that SSB was more about how you live a life. So sir, I changed my routine all in all. Sir, I joined Decathlon, which gave more exposure to me. Decathlon helped me communicate more, improve my communication. It made my routine strict. So I was adhering to my timetable more. I started observing things, I started questioning things. So these are certain changes which I made in my routine so as to organize myself better and represent myself better the next time I come for SSB.
Okay, so Rishabh, you didn't give the NDA exam?
So I gave the NDA exam, twice I gave the exam.
Twice you gave the NDA exam?
Yes sir.
You could not clear?
Yes sir.
Why?
Sir, studies is something sir where I've always been low sir. My interest has always been towards co-curricular activities and sports sir. I always listen to my heart. My heart has always been inclined towards sports and co-curricular activities sir. So that is why I feel that I couldn't do my NDA.
But if I see your 10th and 12th marks, you have scored very well in 12th standard.
Sir, it is because sir, in the last days, I give my 100% sir. In the last days, I just mug up things and I am able to deliver those things and in my written exam.
Okay, so if I see, you have played a lot of sports.
Yes, sir.
Which is your favorite sport?
Sir, my favorite sport at the moment would be badminton, sir.
Okay, so you love playing badminton?
I love playing badminton.
And who's your favorite player?
So my favorite player is Lee Chong Lee, sir.
Okay. He belongs to which country?
He belongs to Malaysia.
Malaysia. So how do you update yourself?
Sir, I update myself by watching YouTube videos, sir. In terms of sports, I update myself through newspaper. Also, sir, whenever I'm with my friends, we always discuss about things, ongoing things, past things, present things. So that way, I update myself.
So, if I ask you, tell me something about the 5 important international or national news in last 1 month.
Sir, 5 important international news would be, the number one I would like to talk about the Guam Island issue, which is between North Korea and America. Number 2 would be the ASEAN summit, which recently is ongoing in Bonn. And number 3 would be sir, I would tell you during the course of the interview, sir. 5 national news would be, number 1 would be, sir, the ongoing recapitalization, sir, reform in the economy. Number 2 would be the, in the northeast, the demand of a greater Nagaland. Number 3 would be, so there's a constant insurgency which is going in Jammu and Kashmir, which is always in the news, sir. So in the past 1 month, we've seen a lot of encounters and involvement of a lot of political parties like Hurriyat in these incidences. That's all, sir.
Okay. So Rishabh, what do you think that what are the qualities that you have which makes you a suitable candidate for armed forces?
Sir, I would say that I have got an analytical mindset. Being logical and practical are the principles of my life and I always adhere by them. Being in the army lifestyle throughout my childhood, I have always learned from my father, my grandfather who was also in the army, and the officers that I have observed, that they have got a very analytical and practical mind. Therefore, I feel that that is one quality which is good in me. So number 2 quality would be, I am good in sports. So being good in sports gives me advantage physically. So I feel that I am physically good, and this would help me in the army. So number three would be, I have always observed and I have always felt that army officers are all-rounders. And if you see my records, I have always been all-rounder. I have received all-rounder awards throughout my schooling career. And I feel that I am good. I'm jack of all and king of none, sir. So that I feel is something which is an advantage for me, sir.
Okay, so Rishabh, do you have a girlfriend?
Sir, I don't have a girlfriend exactly, but there is somebody who I like, and she also likes me, but we are not in a relationship at the moment.
Okay, so you know, both of you know the feelings of each other?
Yes, sir.
So
even our parents know, sir.
Parents also know?
Yes, sir.
So what are your plans related to her?
Sir, my plans are very clear, sir. For me to give a commitment, I need to have something to back that commitment, sir. So I was, from the day one, I was very honest with her. I told her my feelings. She also expressed her feelings. But I told her that to give you commitment, I must have something to back that commitment. And at the moment, I don't have anything. So I would like to get settled in life so that I can back that commitment and then go forward with it.
Okay. So how did you tell your parents about that?
Sir, I told my mother about after a month when we decided that when we shared our feelings. So I told her, my mother, sir, and nothing special, sir. She was sitting and I came home and I told her that, okay, there's something like this. I met this person who is from college and it has been an ongoing thing, and presently we have decided this. So, and my mother told my father, and that's how they got to know about it.
Okay, so does the father of the girl know?
Yes, sir.
So, they don't have any objection?
No, sir, not at all, sir.
Okay. So, before that, did you have any feeling for any other girl?
No, sir. Before that, yes, sir, I had feelings, sir. I was in boys' school. I came to college. That was my first interaction with girls. And I was part of dance team also, sir. So, we were dancing. So, I had a team member in my dance team with whom I had certain affection. But it only stayed till an affection, sir, because she left college after her first year. She changed her college, she migrated it to some other college. And then due to miscommunication, sir, that liking could not develop into something else, sir. And then life progressed.
Then you were there in the Western dance in your college.
Yes, sir.
So there must be a lot of girls who would have proposed you.
Sir, in college, sir, there have been two girls who have proposed me, but not in dance. But yes, sir, you can say that through dance, seeing me perform on stage, they got to know about me.
So, what did you say to them?
Sir, for me, it is something of an infatuation. So, I have always been very clear that something like this is always an infatuation. It's a momentary thing. So, I told both of them the same thing, that I would like to spend more time with you, like to know you more, but then we can see how things progress. But at the moment, let's restrict ourselves to friendship.
Okay, so Rishabh, how do you rate your performance this time?
Sir, I would rate myself far better than my other two performances. I have been very satisfied and very happy with my performance so far.
Okay, and if I tell you to rate yourself on a scale of 10, how much marks you want to give yourself?
So I would give myself 10. 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10. So this time you're damn sure of getting recommended?
Damn sure, sir, with your blessings, definitely.
Okay. All the best.
Thank you, sir.